Hello guys, and welcome back to the Thermal Mods series. In this video, we'll not go through new stuff, but I'm using things I have covered in the series so far to make a Netherrack, Crucible, Lava, Steam power plant. And if you want to go deeper into any of these items, just check the playlist, all right? So it works like this. We put Netherrack in this chest and we get power out over here. But in between there, and of course we have some water coming in, so this water from the accumulator is coming to all these, but you can't really see it. And Netherrack to lava will cost you, let's see, Crucible 60k RF. At least in this mod pack. If you play in a different mod pack, this value might be different. But Netherrack is quite easy to farm. It's very quick to mine, so you can very quickly get a few stacks. And if you're mining a lot in the Nether, I mean, at least in my experience, you often end up with chests or crates or barrels filled with Netherrack. And this is a good way to turn them into energy, and with this setup you can also have it automatically shut down and so on. In many setups you don't need to have them turned off because when they're full we just stop. But with steam that doesn't really work, because if you produce more steam than you're using, the excess steam will just be wasted. It will disappear. So You should add a few automatic shutdowns. But let's take it in order. This crucible is set to run on high signal. That means that I can always turn this lever on to override. But when it's off, it's set to auto. And this chest will output, let's see. If we have more than one, more or equal to one, we'll get high. But that means that if we remove this, we'll get zero. It's enough just to put one single in there and we get one as an output. So as soon as we have anything in this chest, the system will run. But that also means that you will have a stack here that will be as a buffer, so to say. So if you're out of energy, out of material, you might have some leftovers here and you can just kickstart with this lever. But that's only for making it run, and we'll come back to how to turn it off as well. We will use this servo. This is set to low. That means that if we have no signal coming in, then this will be running. And by the way, this is configured as this. Well, I don't know the name for it, but it means that we can just pump things in and out of the machine or whatever. In this case, it means that we are sucking the lava out and just distributing it to all these magmatic dynamos. All these are resonant and they are upgraded with the boiler conversion to get steam and then three fuel catalyzers to get even more out of the lava. And then we ascend the steam. And here, as you can see, I'm not mixing those. If you just place them down, they will look like this. But I don't think that's a good idea, because they will split in one way and then will split again, and these will split this way. There will be lots of splits, and you don't really need that, because this one can produce at the maximum 240 millibuckets per tick of steam. And the steam dynamo, also the resonant version, upgraded with the turbine conversion, can use at most 240 millibuckets. So this can produce as much as this can use. And this means that if we're producing we're using 240, we will produce the double in RF. And this will just output this one. So in the next step, to have this one turn off everything, I'm checking the content, the energy level here, and we can do this with the relay. And I set it to 12, and threshold 12 means that we're outputting a high signal, and 12 out of 15, or however they count, it's 40 million. So when we reach 40, this will turn off and send the signal over here. And this will send up the high output, which will turn this one off. So if we start to empty this one, like that, we're emptying this energy cell into this, and this means that once we reach 40, this will be low and everything will turn on. So let's see how that looks. Any time now. There it is. And we are, well, it's a bit below actually. So now we can remove that. And now we can see this one is running. Lava is being produced and put on into all these. This setup is built, and as you might have noticed, I didn't set this to maximum. I set it on 12. And that means that all the lava in the crucible will stay there, because it's this one we're turning off. But all the lava in these ones, they can hold 4 buckets each. So that's 4 times 7, right? Yeah. That's 21 buckets of lava that will still be used up and turned into steam and energy. So that's why I didn't set it to like 15 or something. So we'll continue to add some energy here, even though we've turned this one off. And this is probably, well, if this is out, then we'll get a 0 here, and that means a 0 here. And this needs high to run, so we're not producing anything else, but all these will still continue to run. Okay, if you have any questions on this setup, well, perhaps you wonder how much it produces. Well, if all of these 7 are running, we should be around 3360 RF per tick. So keep that in mind. I'm using the highest tier of Fluiducts. That means 25k. This is also 25. But if you have some lower tier, then just make sure you can handle the 3300. And it seems like, no, this is full. So now everything is turned off over here. And this will just be filled up. And when this internal buffer is full, we will just, the crucible will stop by itself. So even if I put it on override, it will still don't run because we're full. All right, very simple. If you have any more questions, you know where to leave them. Thanks for watching. And bye-bye.